In the previous video, I covered all the options for becoming an iOS developer, but in this video, I want to lay out a step-by-step plan for you to actually achieve it. So at a high level, the previous video covered the following options for becoming an iOS developer: self-teaching via course, attending a university or college program, or joining a bootcamp. And if I were to start all over from day one, I think I would choose to learn on my own. There are just so many good resources out there, including my own, where someone can just pick up this skill. So with the self-teaching option in mind, here's step one of how to become an iOS developer step by step. The first step to becoming an iOS developer begins before you even start learning, and it is to prepare yourself mentally. Don't underestimate the power of mindset because it drives your actions. If you start this journey with the wrong mindset, you will fail. So here are three things that I would do to have a successful mindset. Here's thing number one. I remember when I first started teaching iOS back in 2013 and I noticed the pattern. Some people would learn iOS and go on to find jobs and launch apps in the store while others would give up pretty early on. There were rarely people who would make it halfway and then call it quits. When I asked the quitters why they quit, it would always be something along the lines of, it was harder than I thought, or I didn't have time, or coding wasn't for me. Now my issue with these reasons is that they're flimsy excuses for not achieving your goal and why you're quitting. An actual deal-breaking reason to quit would be something like, my Mac blew up and I can't use it anymore. Or I broke my finger, so I'm gonna have to pause this for now. So this led me to draw this learning curve to help people visualize the journey of learning iOS development. I called it the hump. Terrible name, right? Comment below if you have a better name and I may adopt it. It starts off easy and you're enjoying yourself, but starts to ramp up in challenge and frustration. At this point, if you thought it was going to be a walk in the park to launch your own app, or that you learn the skills for a six-figure job in a couple of months, you'll quit, I guarantee it. Because your expectation is so far from reality that when reality finally hits, it's a steep drop. But if you persist, work through the frustration and challenge, and learn from your mistakes, you'll make progress, little by little. And then after a certain point, things will get easier and you will reach your goal. Here's the interesting thing though. The learning material and skills required, they do not get easier. In fact, they get more complex as you progress. But my observation is that people either quit here in the beginning or they reach their goal. So what gives? Why would the material be the most complex here, yet the difficulty is also the lowest here? The reason is because the graph doesn't measure objective difficulty of the material. It measures your perception of the difficulty of the material. And why is that more important? It comes back to mindset. Let me walk you through it. In the beginning, you're not sure if you can achieve your goal. It's starting to get harder and harder, and it's beginning to seem like reaching your goal is less and less likely. And that's when many people will give up, especially those who thought it was going to be easy. But you're different. You stick with it and you struggle a bit. Through little successes and small wins here and there, something begins to change in your mind. You start realizing that you can do it, and that's all it takes, really. Perceived difficulty starts going down as confidence in yourself rises, even though the material is getting more complex. So to sum it up, have realistic expectations about the time it'll take and the commitment it's going to require from you to gain these valuable iOS app development skills. You will encounter frustration, but it'll be worth it in the end. And this leads me to thing number two. If you were learning a new skill, how long do you think it would take? Perhaps you've heard of the 10,000 hour rule for mastery in Malcolm Gladwell's book, Outliers. But have you heard of another book by Josh Kaufman called The First 20 Hours? His research led him to believe that if you spend just 20 hours of deliberate practice on the right skills, you can get pretty good at whatever skill you're learning. Now, whether that's true or not, I'm not going to debate that, but it is the inspiration behind this strategy. And that's to open up your calendar and pencil in 20 one-hour sessions to learn iOS development. This way, you're going to prioritize it with the other things that are going on in your life. Plus, it gives you a short-term goal. More on why that's important a little later. Now, let me tell you a story. I turned 40 this year, and it's the first time in my life that I've been able to consistently get exercise. Why? Because I finally made room for it in my daily routine, and I prioritize it just as highly as everything else in my life. And now it's just a part of my day, and I don't have to give it a second thought. So don't try to learn iOS on top of everything else going on in your life. Make a routine spot on your calendar, preferably a quiet time where you can be undisturbed, and prioritize it. Finally, we come to thing number three. We all have a reason to become an iOS developer. Oh, it's going to be great when I'm working at Apple and making hundreds of thousands of dollars each year. Or, I can just imagine my app going viral and making millions from the App Store. The problem is that it's a long, long journey. And when you're struggling, in pain, tired, you want to quit, you can feel like you'll never reach that end result. You might as well quit now and watch some Netflix, right? This might help. Set two goals instead of just having one. The long-term goal. You know, this is the initial reason that caused you to embark on this journey. And also have a short-term input-based goal. This could be a goal of doing 20 one-hour sessions before even thinking of quitting. Or maybe you'll commit to learning for at least 2 months before considering quitting. The important thing is that it is near-term and it's input-based, meaning that it's within your control because you can control how much time and effort you input. So thing number three is to have two goals. The long-term goal, which reminds you of why you're on this journey, but the short-term goal helps you keep making progress bit by bit. Do you notice that all three mindset strategies are to prevent you from quitting prematurely? And sometimes that's all it takes. If you just persist a little bit longer past the frustration, there's a high chance that you'll succeed. Okay, next, step number two is very important because guess what? There's a ton of stuff you don't need to learn in iOS development and you can still reach your goal. You can dramatically reduce the time it takes to reach your goal by selectively choosing only the specific skills you need, and it all depends on what your goal is. And that's what I'm going to break down for you in step two, and it's in the next video, so make sure you hit subscribe so you don't miss it. In the meantime, please comment below which is your favorite mindset strategy. Number one, having realistic expectations. Number two, penciling in the sessions on your calendar. Or number three, having two goals instead of just one. All right, thanks for watching, and we're going to continue this how to become an iOS developer step by step in the next video. I'll see you there.